From Japanese to Swiss brands, there is a diver for every budget, including those that blur the line between entry level and luxury. In today's market, it is becoming increasingly difficult to locate smaller boutique brands that are managed by individuals who genuinely enjoy watches. A very good example in this regard is the Baltic Aquascaf, that appears to have been constructed and designed by watch enthusiasts who desire to provide an enjoyable dive watch experience with a vintage aesthetic and a reasonable price. The Aquascaf is Baltic's first dive watch and the successor to their wildly popular Bicompax chronograph. The Aquascaf pulls at the heartstrings of dive watch aficionados with a variety of intriguing details and a strong value statement. Can this be the cutest diver you have ever seen? Starting from the dimensions, with a 39mm case that measures 47mm lug to lug and 12mm at the top of the bubble domed sapphire crystal, the Aquascaf is an approachable and easy to wear size from the get-go. The width of the case is in fact 38mm, but the bezel makes it a 39mm overall. The screw-down crown is expansive and free of crown guards. The Aquascaf has a water resistance of 200 meters, a brush steel case back and drill lugs. Basically, it ticks all the boxes. Like I just said, judged by its dimensions and look, this is the cutest diver I have ever seen lately. Lovely lume sapphire bezel insert with a light font and marking layout that complements the dial's simplicity and legibility because the Aquascaf is only offered without a date. With minimal dial text and sandwich style triangle markers at 3, 6 and 9 o'clock position, although this is a subtle distinction, these three painted markers interact with the matte black or brush blue dial in a completely different manner than the other painted markers. With Miyota's straightforward and dependable 90-39 movement, which is slim at only 3.9mm, this Japanese caliber ticks at 4Hz or 28,800 beats per hour. Features both automatic and manual winding and has a power reserve of over 42 hours. This is a nice and novel approach from a company that chose to use a non-Seiko caliber. Miyota is a citizen-owned watchmaker known for its quality. The beads of rice bracelet created by Baltic is worth the cost. It looks fantastic. It is comfortable, has a nice weight on the wrist, and the bracelet's mixed finishing brings out the best of the Aquascaf design. In many ways, the Aquascaf is reminiscent of an old dive watch, like so many of the unnamed models that appeared in the 1960s when diving was fashionable. The Aquascaf is endowed with a warm charisma and a nod to the history of dive watch design. The Aquascaf is a meticulously crafted dive watch offered at a very reasonable price. Baltic is one of the few micro brands of watches that cares about its customers. I have a soft spot for vintage inspired timepieces, specifically dive watches. This is a solid example of a micro brand product that is comfortable to wear, of a good size, fashionable, and clearly the product of a watch enthusiast. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. It will help me a lot to bring more quality content. Thank you very much. I would strongly recommend the Baltic Aquascaf to anyone in search of a small batch watch that does not resemble or feel like many other models in the same price range. Speaking about the price, this puts the Aquascaf on par with Yema Navigraph, another French vintage inspired dive watch from a boutique brand called Yema. With a vintage design that doesn't rely too heavily on the vintage watches that came before it, a thoughtfully designed bracelet and a nearly ideal 39mm size, the Aquascaf is an excellent option for both the serious diver and the desk diver.